What's up guys, I'm DekaCrafter, and today I'm going to show you how to set up custom maps on a server so that you and your friends can play adventure maps, parkour maps, whatever it is that you want to do. Now you can use whatever website you want to, it really doesn't matter, but I'm just going to use minecraftmaps.com for the sake of this tutorial. There is one thing you've got to note first before you can start making your server though. If the map you're downloading is for Minecraft version 1.17 or below, you're going to need to download Java 8. The Windows link is going to be in the description. You're just going to click on the Windows Offline 64-bit and make sure you have that downloaded. There's another step we're going to have to do for maps that are like that, but we'll get to that in just a second. Now, it's much easier if you choose an updated map, anything that's 1.18 or above, because then you just download Java 17, which link for that's going to be in the description as well. You're going to scroll down, click Windows, and use the 64 installer right here. Big heads in the way. And we're going to go with a 1.16.5 so I can show you the last step that you need if you're going to use maps that are anything below 1.18. So 1.17 and below, there's a special step you have to do for your server to work, and we're going to go over that. Now the map I downloaded is for Minecraft 1.16.5, so what I'm going to do is actually set up a paper Minecraft server. I'm going to have a link to this website as well in the description, and we can see all the different versions of Minecraft right over here. So we're going to go to 1.16.5. And we're just going to use the most updated one at the top there. Alright, now we can see our downloads in our download folder. What I'm going to do, just for simplicity reasons, is drag it onto my desktop. Now if your desktop's linked to OneDrive, you'll see a loading icon or a check mark or an X or something on your icons. That means that it's connected to the cloud, and servers don't work on the cloud, so if it's connected to the cloud, go figure out how to get it off. Now once you've got it on your desktop, we're going to open up our map download, and we're actually just going to take this file and drag it out of here. Alright, now we've got our map outside of the zip folder, so we can go ahead and delete the zip. Yes. We're going to create a new folder. Again, if your desktop's linked to OneDrive, that means you have your server on cloud storage, and this is not going to work. Then what you want to do is take these two files here and drag them into our new Minecraft server folder. Open it up. We're actually going to rename this paper file. We're just going to rename it to server. And then this, we're going to rename the custom world to world. Now what we're going to do is create yet another new, except this time text document. We're gonna name it run. Now we're gonna open it up. All right, and in your run, you're gonna type this, Java, all lowercase, minus symbol, capital X, lowercase ms, one, capital G. So this is starting your server with 1 gig of RAM. This is setting the max to 2 gigs of RAM. And then we're looking for a jar file. The jar file we're looking for is this one here, server.jar. And we're gonna make it so there's no GUI. Once you've got this typed out, you can set the RAM to whatever you need. We're going to go to File, Save As, run.bat, and hit Save. So that's done. You can actually delete this text document. Now, since we're doing 1.16.5, and we have multiple versions of Java installed, we're actually going to need to change this here. Instead of the word Java, what we have to do, because we're using not the latest version of Java, and your computer is going to automatically try to use the latest version, we have to tell it which version to use. If you want, you can just copy this from the description as well to make it easier. Put a quote, paste it, end it with a quote, go back into the quote and add slash java.exe. And now our run.bat knows to use that specific version of Java. So now when we go to run our server, it's going to do a first time setup. In Minecraft, we're also going to need to set our game to the version of Minecraft that the server is running. Alright, for the first time setup, it's going to crash. You're going to see this file called a EULA. You're just going to change this false to true. Save. Alright, and then you're going to run the server again. And now it's actually going to run for real. So you don't want to close this black window. This is literally your server. So now we're going to go to installations here. We're going to do new installation. Change this to 1.16.5. We're just going to name it 1.16.5. More options. It's already using 2 gigs of RAM, so we're all good. Create. And then, if we go to play, we can change this to the 1.16.5 one we had just created, right down here at the bottom, and hit play. Now, to join your server, it's going to be different for you and your friends. You're going to join for the IP. You're just going to put a 0, or you can type in the word localhost. However, for your friends to join, you're going to have to click away from this video in the description. You're going to see a port forwarding tutorial. Your friends are going to need your public IP, which you can see on canyouseeme.org, but your public IP is not going to be useful to you until you've port forwarded. But if we go to add server, We're just going to put a zero. Adventure map. Done. Scroll down. Hit play. Now we've got our custom adventure map server. We can see that we joined it right here. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and I'll see you in the next one.